Senator Kamala Harris released a letter yesterday calling on the Bureau of Prisons to reduce the federal inmate population amid the coronavirus outbreak. But is it safe to release these prisoners, and what impact will that have on our communities? Let's bring in now former police officer and former member of the Joint Terrorism Task Force, Steve Rogers. Steve, good morning.
Good morning to you.
What do you make of this request from Harris? Should we be concerned as U.S. citizens that our prisons are about to be opened?
The first thought I have was that if you're not victimized by the virus, you're most likely going to be victimized by one of these criminals who are released. Keep in mind that these aren't shoplifters that they're releasing. I'm hearing that many of these people have been charged with assault, robbery. Many of them have maybe affiliation with gang members. These are bad people. And the problem we're facing is that there's no way to monitor them. There's no plan to keep an eye on them. They're without jobs, without money, without food. So what do we expect? What I expect is that there'll be a bit of a spike in crime in certain areas that they're going to be released.
You know, I've had sources tell me earlier this week that on these phone calls that they're having on the congressional side anyway, one of their concerns, and they were bringing this up as early as Sunday night, was what happens to the nation's cities if you start to go on lockdown. People aren't getting paychecks. They're stuck in their homes. Not everyone has honest intentions, and they're concerned about looting in America's cities. They're concerned about robberies. They're concerned about attacks, even just petty theft if someone's on the streets. Is it too early to have that discussion, Steve?
No, it isn't. We should be having it now, and there should be a plan, as took place when we had the swine flu, when we had the AIDS epidemic. Prisoners were not released.
I'm not talking about prisoners. I'm talking about people that are out there. You know, the criminal element that is living in American cities, not those in prison, but those folks that are desperate, that are home with no money. Are they going to go out on the street and do something nefarious?
Well, it's very possible that could happen. This is why we must be vigilant. We must not hesitate to call the police if we see suspicious people in our neighborhoods. Danger to law enforcement is a real thing now. Yes, there is a possibility that we could see a spike in crime. But saying that, if people are vigilant and keep an eye on their neighborhoods and their homes, I don't see that there'll be a major epidemic of crime in this country.
Here in New York, Mayor de Blasio wants the federal government to bring in the National Guard. He wants more federal help. Some of it's money, but obviously he's looking at security as well. Are we at that point?
No, we're not at that point, especially the New York City Police Department's one of the best police departments in the country. I've been around. I've talked to law enforcement officers in small towns and large cities. Things are pretty well secure right now. This is going to be a police-public partnership in keeping our homes and our cities and towns safe. So we're not at that point. I think that's a little bit of an overreaction right now.
Good, good. I'm glad to hear that it is. Steve Rogers. Steve, it's always great to have you here, sir. Thank you.
Pleasure. Thank you.
All right, Lauren.
All right. Well, Netflix is slow.